I don't know about you, but one of the things that I most preciously value on my old PS4 is my digital copy of PT, the playable teaser for the unfortunately cancelled Silent Hills. This is in large part, of course, because following Kojima's departure from Konami and the cancellation of the project, PT was removed from the PlayStation Store outright. What this means is that only those who downloaded PT and haven't deleted the files will have access to the game now. For everyone else, you're either out of luck, or you'll have to find some illicit means to re-download the game onto your PS4. There have been a few attempts to recreate PT for PC and the like, but Konami quickly shut those down, which I personally don't get the point of when PT was a free game anyway, and Konami doesn't seem to have plans to do anything with it moving forward. Now, given how limited access is for PT, you can imagine the horror people felt when rumors began to spread that the game was being completely disabled for some people. This rumor began in the Silent Hill subreddit via a user going by the name of Populous Tricokerpa, who posted a thread titled, "I can't access PT anymore, even though it is downloaded and I have it purchased. Anyone else?" Accompanying the post is a screen grab featuring information on the game, and interesting to note here is how the game was seemingly updated on October 22nd, 2018 at 7:52 p.m., how the game's version is listed as 1.01 rather than the 1.0 that would normally be displayed, and how the application's starting tab is labeled ineligible. As soon as people saw this, word began to spread like wildfire, and a wide variety of major media outlets began to cover this. Now, when other people checked their own copies, myself included, there didn't seem to be anything out of place. When I went to make sure, I found that my copy of PT ran just fine without any hitches, and many others were reporting the same. So then the assumption became that this rumored Killswitch patch for PT may be being released in waves across different regions. But a few days went by and PT continued to function as it normally did, with no update to be found. Now, I myself disabled automatic updates on my PS4 just in case, but there haven't been any widespread reports of the game being updated with a new patch. Media outlets eventually began reaching out to Konami for official word on these rumors, and as it turns out, it would seem as though the rumors were not true after all. Responding to inquiry by website IGN, here's what Konami had to say. "After our investigation, we can confirm that there have been no Konami or PlayStation Network update that would have affected or prevent access to the game." In other words, there is no such thing as a game-crippling patch for PT that Konami deployed, and this Reddit user seems to be nothing but a troll. I would imagine that this screen grab here was likely doctored, as there is nobody else who has been able to replicate these conditions as far as we know. So for those out there who are freaking out about Konami going out of their way to cripple the only remnant of one of the most unfortunate project cancellations, worry no more. Funny thing is that given Konami's history, it wouldn't have been at all surprising if they actually did pull something like this. Ever since their feud with Kojima, they have been determined to eliminate every possible trace of the man from the company's records, as highlighted by how they removed his name from the cover art of his own games, or how they prevented him from attending the Game Awards to accept his trophy for Metal Gear Solid V: The Phantom Pain, among many other things. But it's one thing to remove an employee's name from the cover art, and it's a whole other thing to retroactively invade and cripple consumers' downloads and purchases with a malicious patch. I would like to think that even Konami isn't dumb enough to step over that line, as that would be asking for one hell of a shitstorm. Me personally, I'm still keeping automatic updates on my old PS4 with PT in it, disabled just as a precaution in case this incident gives Konami any ideas. While I do get the sense that this won't really end up being a problem in the long run, you really never know. For now though, while there are plenty of reasons to hate Konami, fortunately messing with our downloaded copies of PT isn't one of them, and let's hope that stays that way. With that, I would like to end this news update and discussion video. Thank you for tuning in. If you enjoy my content and would like to support this channel directly, consider donating on Patreon. And to be further updated on all things gaming news, reviews, and discussions, stay tuned right here on Yong Ye. I'll see you guys next time. Yong out.